everybody, and welcome back to the Integrity Botanicals YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you a new product launch that I think we're all pretty pumped about. It's from Well People, and it is their new Optimist lipstick. Oh my god. I really go back and forth between what my favorite makeup product is, but lipstick is the one where I seem to justify having the most of, because it's like, it's a little more pink, it's a little more red, and Well People kind of snatched my wig right off, and I'm so in love with these lipsticks, and I can't wait to share them with you. So really quickly, let's start with packaging. I love the packaging on them too. That's not hurting one bit. They're in these sort of silvery tubes. They're just like a hard plastic. It says Well People across the front here, and my favorite, they have a button at the top. Boom, you click and the color comes right out. On the bottom here, you'll see that the sticker is in the same vein as the color that's inside. It's not exactly the same, but it will give you enough distinction between the bullets to tell you what's what, and it has the shade name, and they are all numbered. So there are 6 beautiful shades in the line. They are $17, so I think, you know, it's not a cheap lipstick by any means, but in the green beauty space, I think that's right there in the middle, along with the majority of the Well People line. I think they have a really reasonable price point, really great ingredients inside, and these are gluten-free and certified organic. I'll have more information on that down below, a full ingredients list, so you guys can check it out. But some of the main ingredients inside of here are organic shea butter, jojoba oil, and castor oil. A lot of beautiful oils that are in many, many green beauty products, but these are just extra special. And I think they're so extra special because the formula of them is this semi-matte texture. I am wearing one on my mouth right now. So they are more on the matte side, but they're not flat and stiff. They still have quite a bit of moisture and hydration to them, so I can still push my lips together. They are not transfer proof, which is not something that I mind. However, they are incredibly long wearing. The pigment really stays around for a long time, whether it be the nude shades or the deeper shades in this line, which I just adore. The texture of them is really, really light as well. It's not thick. Like the Gressa Lip Boosts have a thickness to them that I don't mind, because since they're so hydrating, that keeps them on the mouth. But these have really great moisture. The pigmentation is just gorgeous on them, and the texture is unique, and I think something that so many of us can get down with. And the shade range, I like them all. I can't believe I'm saying that. I like them all. Mind you, there are only 6 shades, but I think they did such a great job with making them all different enough, yet very wearable, and I look forward to seeing more shades come out in the future. But that's my thoughts and opinions on the lipsticks. I'm crazy about them, you guys. This is one of those products, like the lip serums from Fit Glow, where I'm like, this is one of the new favorites, and I've just been reaching for them nonstop. So let's start off with the first shade. This is in the shade number 1, Soulmate, which is a very, very cute name, and this is the most peachy, pinky sort of shade in the bunch, yet really, really wearable, not too pale. Pigmentation is nice and rich. I first put this on with no makeup, and I was like, ugh, that's not gonna look good on me. But then I did a little bit of a liner. Even when I have a full face of makeup on, I like it even without a liner. I think it's really, really pretty, and definitely going to be a hit with those of you who like your peachy pinky nudes, especially one that is going to be nice and long wearing. Next up is shade number 2. This is one of my favorites in the line for sure. This is the shade Choose Love, and Choose Love is a lot more pink than the first shade mentioned. It's actually super pink, yet not a bubblegum pink, yet it is still a little bit more cool toned. So it's very brightening. I like layering this with glosses. You could sort of take this many different directions depending on the liner, depending on the lip gloss, etc. It's just a nice true pink that isn't too light, yet still is nude enough where if you have a lot going on in the eyes, you just slap this on and it's really pretty, but very, very unique shade that I'm quite a big fan of. Shade number 3, this is the shade Let It Go, and this one is, we're getting quite a bit deeper now. This one is much more of that Kylie Jenner sort of mauve-y shade, so this is right there in the middle. Probably going to be the most universally flattering. Obviously, on a more deep complexion, this will pull more pink on you, and on someone like me, the brown, purpley tones in it are very much coming through, which I think is great for this time of year, yet is still very wearable everyday lipstick. So big, big fan of that one. Moving on to shade number 4, which is the shade Om Yeah, and this is the shade I have on my lips right now. I don't have it super full on. You can definitely build it up more, but it's just a beautiful berry magenta sort of shade, yet it doesn't have much red in it. It is a very true pink. I would say maybe even a little bit of purple in it that's giving it that berry tone. You can see it sort of matches my dress that I'm wearing right now, yet I still really like this lipstick. I think it's bold without being crazy. It's not neon. It's not red, like I said. It is still definitely a pink, just a nice rich one. I think on a dark complexion, this would just be stunning, especially for a good wearable fall tone shade. I think this would be fantastic. Moving on to the shade number 5. This is in the shade New Mystic, and New Mystic is the most purpley of the bunch for sure. It's just a purple, more deep tone shade. These shades normally I don't love how they look on me, but this one I'm quite a big fan of. Again, very, very unique because it's a little bit berry, a little bit purple, yet still wearable. Again, another one I think would look great, great, great on a deep toned complexion, yet I do think is universally flattering as well, whether you be pale. As long as you get down with purples, then I think this would be a fantastic one for you. And finally, the deepest in the bunch, of course, is the shade number 6. And this is the shade Retrograde. And Retrograde is a very beautiful red. They don't have any sort of true, bold, bright reds, but this one has quite a bit of brown to it. It's more of a bricky red. And I love these kind of reds, actually, especially in the fall, winter months, because just with like a very minimal on the eye or even a heavy smoky eye, I think this pairs so beautifully, and that bit of brown that's mixed in with the red makes it more wearable for all skin tones. Like, I love a very pale orange, like true redhead in this sort of shade. I love an ebony goddess in this sort of shade, and I like myself in the shade as well, and I sort of sit right in the middle, leaning towards the fair side, especially when I dye my hair red. But I think they've just done such a great job where I think most people can get away with these shades, maybe with the exception of the first two, but the last four are wearable. There's diversity amongst the shades. They've done a really great job without any of that repetition, because that's something that I think green beauty brands do the most. It's like in the middle, you'll see, I could sort of interchange all of that. I don't need all of those. You could sort of scrap those and I wouldn't really miss them. But well, people, you've done an amazing job. Seeing as they're the Optimist lipsticks, I'm feeling very optimistic towards them. They're making me very, very happy, which I think is a beautiful thing. And if you guys like that more matte lipstick texture, but you have dry lips, like yours truly, I have the driest lips ever, and you could see it's not tugging, it's not pulling, they're not bleeding. I did all the swatches without liner. They're really fantastic, guys, and last a very, very nice amount of time for a very reasonable price point, in my opinion. As always, ingredients list, product link, it's gonna be down below. I will also include full swatches so you guys can see these in relation to each other. In the video, I played them on my mouth, just so you can get an idea of what they look like on different skin tones. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you're as excited about them as I am. Let me know what your favorite shade is down below. Thank you so much for watching. Any questions, please don't hesitate to ask, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Bye.